Hello students, today's topic of presentation is bipolar junction transistor introduction from chapter 3 bipolar junction transistor, subject basic electronics 22225. Now we'll understand the construction of bipolar junction transistor, and the very first thing we are going to understand is the definitions, so that what is bipolar junction transistor you would be able to understand clearly. So as you know, there are two types of semiconductors, extrinsic semiconductors. They are p-type and n-type. The things which are supposed to be revised, so if it is a n-type of extrinsic semiconductor, then there are two types of carriers in n-type of semiconductor. So one is majority carrier, one is minority carrier. Majority carriers are electrons, minority carriers are holes. And in p-type of semiconductor, there are two types of carriers again. Majority carriers are holes and minority carriers are electrons. So these are two types of extrinsic semiconductors. Now, to construct a bipolar junction transistor, these two semiconductors are used in such a way that it forms a three-layer device. So one type of semiconductor is used twice, and the other semiconductor is placed in between that semiconductor. So for example, transistor, as a definition, transistor is a three-layer semiconductor device. So it is a three-layer device. So three out of these three layers, the first layer will be a n-type of semiconductor, then second will be p-type of semiconductor, then third will be again n-type of semiconductor. So p-type of semiconductor is sandwiched between two n-type of semiconductor. Otherwise, if first layer is p-type of semiconductor, the second layer will be n-type of semiconductor, and third layer will be again p-type of semiconductor. That means n-type of semiconductor is sandwiched between two p-type of semiconductor. So hence, there are two types of bipolar junction transistors. So as you can see in the slide, one is PNP transistor and other is NPN transistor. So PNP transistor means p-type of semiconductor, then n-type of semiconductor, and then again p-type of semiconductor. So it forms a three layer, and since whenever p and n-type of semiconductors are joined, a depletion layer is formed always, as you know about this in diode. So that depletion layer is formed. So as it is a three layer device, so one junction is formed between PN, first PN, so that is junction, and the other is junction is also formed, that is depletion layer is also formed between N and P. So there are two junctions as well. So it is a three layer device, and there is always a two junction in the single transistor. So NPN transistor also, N type of semiconductor and P type of semiconductor are joined, there one junction will be there, and then P type of semiconductor and N type of semiconductor are joined, there will be one junction, that is depletion layer. So that forms NPN transistor. So here you can see properly and understand the bipolar junction transistor. So first N type of semiconductor, then P type of semiconductor, then again N, and these two lines between NP and PN are junctions. So that means there will be a depletion layer formed, and these three terminals are there, and the terminal is, one terminal is taken from one N type of semiconductor, the other terminal is taken from other N type of semiconductor, and third terminal is taken from P type of semiconductor. Again, in PNP transistor also three terminals are there. So there are three terminals, and the middle section is thinner than the other. So that the whole detailed construction we'll see later on. So this is what you have to understand first. Now what are the names of the transistor terminals? So transistor has three terminals. The first terminal is called as emitter, the second terminal is called as collector, which is exactly opposite. So that is collector, and the middle terminal is called as base. And here you can see the transistor symbol as well, but this symbol is of NPN transistor. As we know that there are two types of transistor, one is NPN and one is PNP. So both are having different symbols, and this symbol, the symbol of the transistor is shown here, and this one first is the actual transistor. So this is the symbol, and this is the actual transistor. So we will study the transistor in details, naming of the transistor. The transistor has three region named emitter, base and collector. The junction between emitter and base is called emitter base junction, and the junction between base and collector is called collector base junction. The emitter diode is always forward bias and collector diode is reverse bias. Now this we will see in details. So here you can see this is NPN transistor. So this first terminal is emitter. The second terminal at the center terminal is base, which is represented by B, and the last terminal is called as collector, which is represented by C. And the depletion layers, or the, it is called as junctions now. Now since emitter region and base region, the first region, the first semiconductor layer is called emitter region, the central semiconductor layer is called base region, and the third semiconductor region is called as collector region. When emitter and base are connected, there one depletion layer is formed, and that is called as emitter base junction. And where base and collector are joined, there one depletion layer is formed, and that is called as collector base junction. And collector, from the collector one pin will be taken out, that is called as collector terminal. And from base, that pin which comes out for our use for the input, that is base terminal. And from emitter, one terminal will be coming out for metal connection, that is emitter terminal. So here you can see properly. Now the construction details of BJT. So we are going to study that construction of BJT in details, about emitter, base and collector. Now as you can see here, this N type of semiconductor, for this NPN transistor, this is NPN transistor construction basis, construction wise details we are going to see now. So here emitter, why the name emitter? The emitter supplies carriers. Now when you are going to use this as a transistor, the maximum carriers for the current conduction will be supplied by emitters. So it supplies carriers, maximum carriers is supplied by emitter, and therefore it is called as emitter, emitter region. Second thing, it is highly doped. So the concentration of dopants are more in this region. Then the emitter is heavily doped so that it can inject large amount of carriers into the base. Emitter is always, now very important point, emitter is always forward biased with respect to base, so it can supply carrier. So it has to be always forward biased, remember. For NPN transistor, emitter supplies electrons to its junction, and for PNP transistor, emitter supplies holes to its junctions. So if it is NPN transistor, so majority carriers will be electrons, and therefore electrons will be moving from emitter towards base. And if it is PNP transistor, then holes are majority carriers, and holes will be moving from emitter to base. Then is collector terminal, the section on the other side that collects. Now whatever emitter emits the majority carriers, they'll move from emitter, move through the base, and will directly move towards collector, collector region. And therefore as it collects the carrier, it is called collector. Second thing, it is moderately doped. So doping here is not too much, not too less, so medium doping is there. The collector is always reverse biased. Now you have to remember this point. Collector is always reverse biased with respect to base. Now for example, NPN transistor collector receives electrons which will be emitted by the emitter. And if it is NPN transistor, collector receives holes if it is PNP transistor. Next and very important is the base terminal. It is a middle section which forms two PN junction. So always one PN junction is on one side of the base and the other PN junction is on the other side of the base. So between it is also as thin as compared to emitter and collector, remember. So this is the thinnest region. It is very lightly doped. The most lightly doped is base. Then it is lightly doped, so it can pass most of the carriers to the collector. So as when the emitter emits the carriers, when it will move towards base, base is not going to absorb too much of carriers. Whole carriers will be reflected or transferred towards collector region. That is the work of the base. So this was all about the construction of the transistor. I hope you might have understood. Now we'll understand the transistor symbols in details. So it is very important. So since there are two types of transistor, NPN transistor and PNP transistor. So here you can see the image I, the picture I of transistor symbol. So that is of NPN transistor. The arrow you can see going outwards towards emitter terminal. And if the arrow in the transistor is going inside towards base, it is called as PNP transistor. So that is a symbol of transistor you can see for NPN and PNP. And the current direction, the arrow is showing the current direction inside the transistor terminals. So this is the schematic of your transistor. I hope now we will be studying the transistor operation in detail. So how the transistor works, what is the process which goes inside the transistor? So to understand that, first we have to understand if there is a transistor, NPN transistor. So we will be always, since it is most popularly used, so we'll be always checking out with the NPN transistor. So if you are having NPN transistor, it will be having three terminals. Now since there is three terminals, in order to work, to make transistor work, we have to connect power supply or the voltage source to the transistor. Now to connect the voltage source, when we connect the voltage source to a transistor, it is called as biasing. That is the technical term. So to bias the transistor, to apply or connect the voltage source or power supply to the transistor, the first question is how many power supply we should connect. Now as you remember, if you remember the diodes, so diode is having N type of semiconductor and P type of semiconductor are connected together and a single junction is formed, that is called as depletion layer. And to make work diode, you used to connect power supply, but that was single power supply used to connect, that is biasing. So one single power supply was needed. But if you understand transistor, there are two junctions here, so two depletion layers, so we need two power supplies to connect here. Now one power supply will be connected to emitter and base, and the second power supply will be connected to collector and base as shown here. Now the thing is how to connect the power supply, from where positive to be connected, negative to be connected, that is most important. So as we have discussed in the emitter construction, if emitter, if you want to connect to emitter, emitter has to be always forward biased. So forward bias, if you remember while teaching the diode, I told you ki if N and P is there, to forward bias positive, P is positive and N should be connected to negative. So positive to positive and negative to negative connection, when it is done, it is called as forward biasing. So here also, to make a transistor to work, emitter should be forward bias and collector should be reverse bias. So you have to understand here now, emitter is N, base is P. Now N and P is there. Okay? So in order to forward bias, this N and P, first N and P region, emitter and base region, so connect negative to negative and positive to positive. So first you can see here VEB, it is written negative side of the voltage source is connected to first N type emitter and the positive is connected to the base. So this is how it is forward bias. So emitter junction is forward bias. Now the second junction, that is collector junction, that has to be reverse bias. Now reverse bias means if it is N type of semiconductor and P type of semiconductor and voltage has to be connected, so negative to positive and positive to cross connection has to be done. So here you can see second is P and N. P is base and N is collector. So in this base P, so collect, as P is positive, so collect negative. So negative power supply negative terminal is connected to P, and N type, that is collector region, it is connected to positive. So this is reverse bias. This is how the connection is done. Now once you do the connection, then the current starts flowing through the transistor. Now what you have to understand is, since there are three terminals and three regions, so there are actually three currents flowing through transistor. So first name of the current is emitter current, that will be moving through emitter terminal and emitter region, and second current is base current, that will be moving through base terminal, and the third current is collector current, that will be moving through collector terminal. It is shown here IC also, just see IC, IB, IE. IE is emitter current, IB is base current, and IC is collector current. Now what happens, that we are going to see this in details, working of NPN transistor. As we have forward bias emitter base junction, because it is forward bias, the majority carriers in emitter is electrons, since it is your NPN transistor. So majority carriers are electrons. Now electrons are rippled by the negative terminal of the power supply. So therefore they will start moving towards base. And since they start traveling and moving, there is one current called as emitter current. It is because of that. As you know, current is due to the flow of electrons. So when electrons starts flowing, moving, there is a current. So this current is called as emitter current. Sorry. As these electrons flow towards P-type, so these electrons when come towards P-type base, they try to recombine with the holes. Now why holes? The majority carriers in P-type are holes, but kyunki P is very thin region, so holes are very less. So little electrons combines with the holes, but rest of the, as the base is lightly doped, only few electrons recombine with the holes within the base. And these recombined electrons constitute small base current. Because of this recombination, there is small current in the base terminal, that is IB. But the remaining electrons move towards collector and crosses the collector, move towards the collector, move through the collector region, and then move through the collector terminal, and therefore there is one collector current IC. So this IC will move towards the voltage source, and hence there are three currents in the transistor circuit. Whenever you connect the transistor, there will be three current in the transistor. So one is base current, collector current, and emitter current. Now very important is the current equations. Now you have to understand, actually the whole electrons was moving from emitter. For example, 100 electrons were moving through emitter region. Out of that, 10 electrons move toward base terminal, and therefore you got base current, and 10 electrons are moved away, so 90 electrons remaining, so will move towards collector, and that will be moving through the collector terminal, and that is collector current. So basically we can say emitter current is equal to base current plus collector current. So this is the overall equation of the current in the transistor, and this is the working of the transistor, NPN transistor. I hope you have understood the working of transistor. Now this is the symbol of NPN transistor, but here I have actually shown the current directions, very important, and the voltages which are developed when the current flows through the transistor, so in a circuit. So this is very important. So the voltages which develops across collector and emitter, you can see it is shown by VCE. You can see here VCE, which is developed across these terminals. The one more voltage is developed across the terminals base and emitter, that is VBE, and the voltages VB, VE and VC are the different names that the power supply is connected, and then the voltages which develops across the base terminal to ground is VB, and the voltage develops across the emitter to ground is VE. From emitter to ground it is VE, and from collector to ground it is VC. So that is different, but you have to remember about VCE and VBE. I hope you have understood the transistor definition, transistor symbols, transistor working and transistor construction in details, along with the transistor current equations, that is IE, emitter current is equal to base current plus collector current, and the transistor directions also. So you can see the transistor directions here, emitter current. So this is, since this is a NPN transistor, so the arrow on the slant side is downside, so your emitter current will be there, and both the currents, collector current and base current, will be always in the terminals of collector current and base current moving towards emitter. So this is all about the introduction of the transistor. Thank you.